Key properties of enzymes include that most are proteins, although, as you may know, several of them are actually RNA molecules, and those RNA enzymes are called ribozymes. There are about 3,000 different enzymes per cell. That means that cells will have overlapping sets of enzymes. In other words, one cell won't have 3,000 enzymes and another cell has 3,000 totally different ones. They're simply overlapping sets of enzymes, and these characterize the different cells with their different functions. Like any catalyst, enzymes accelerate chemical reactions. How do catalysts work? Well, here's a reaction occurring very slowly in the absence of a catalyst. Reactants are converted to products slowly. Versus a catalyzed reaction, in this case catalyzed by an enzymatic catalyst, happens very fast. And when we look at enzymes, we're talking about substrates being converted to products. So we use the word substrates for reactants in enzyme-catalyzed reactions. Let's compare enzymes, biological catalysts, with some inorganic catalysts. Inorganic catalysts include many of the rare metals, nickel, platinum, silver, and so on. Even hydrogen gas is a catalyst. And the typical enzymes have names like pepsin and trypsin. These are digestive enzymes originally discovered in the stomach in the case of pepsin, in the small intestine, but coming from the pancreas in the case of trypsin. Those are old names. More recently, meaning in the last 30 to 50 years, we've named most enzymes with the ASE at the end. So we have ATP synthase, which does like it says, it catalyzes ATP synthesis. Ribonuclease catalyzes RNA breakdown, which would then mean that deoxyribonuclease catalyzes DNA breakdown. We'll learn common names like these as we go along and look at different enzymes. Again, all enzymes and catalysts have in common that they increase reaction rates. In both cases, the catalysts, enzymes, or inorganic, are unchanged at the end of the reaction. Inorganic catalysts are generally nonspecific, so shavings of platinum can catalyze a large number of different chemical reactions. Enzymes tend to be highly specific. Most of them actually catalyze one and only one reaction involving only one substrate or set of substrates and cannot really catalyze any other chemical reaction. Inorganic catalysts are rigid and inflexible, as you would expect from metals. Enzymes, however, as you would expect from any protein, are flexible, and they can undergo shape change or allosteric change. Allosteric just means alternate shape. Inorganic catalysts cannot be regulated. This is largely because they are rigid and inflexible. Enzymes can be regulated, and this is due to the fact that enzymes can undergo allosteric change, that is, change in shape. And we talk about the regulation of enzymes as, for the most part, allosteric regulation.